we know it's going to be special.
It's picture-perfect postcard.
Forget the setting, great atmosphere.
Up in the big sky.
This was simply outstanding.
One of the biggest events in Pratt's history.
Tonight will be unforgettable. Including that special showdown in Nashville. All eyes on the 2022 NHL Stadium Series game between the Predators and the Lightning, and what a scene it was, nearly 70,000 strong at Nissan Stadium. And these two teams came ready for the hockey talk in their first ever appearance in an NHL outdoor game. The Bolts arrived in their tuxedos, yes, Canadian tuxedos, that is, and while the Lightning opted for the all-jean ensemble, complete with cowboy hats and boots, the hometown Preds look for a bit more of an outlaw vibe, sporting leather jackets and hats, each custom made for all of the players. But all of that fun was before we even dropped the puck, so let's see who was celebrating afterwards on Broadway. Off to Smashville for the highlights.
It's the first ever outdoor game for the Tampa Bay Lightning, the second for the Nashville Predators.
Something good is going on with the National Hockey League, and it is a tough ticket here in Smashville.
The Predators trying to gain possession, and they have it. Here's an opportunity to push out, stop, and it's in! It's knocked in by Janot in front, and the Nashville Predators are out to the early lead with a power play goal.
The turnover by Tampa, and they're all gone. Big rebound, and Janot finds the back of the net.
For a shot by Stamkos.
He goes off the shaft of the stick again there.
Sounded like a puck out of play.
The second one off the stick of Saros. Watch the top part of the stick of the goaltender. There's the shot.
But that's the big difference, right? That's from Rene and Saros. Saros, of course, a lot smaller, so he has to use every tool in the toolbox to make some saves. He's good there.
They find a key to Kucherov. He dropped, carries it deep.
Stays with it, knocks it out of the air, puts it high to the blocker's side after the pass from Kucherov, and the Tampa Bay Lightning tie it up.
Back out for Stamkos. Stamkos for Hedman.
Nikita Kucherov, you can't see him. He's on the left-hand side. He's going to go up to Hedman and then over, and watch his quick little wrister right here. Wow, what a screen on top of that Talon as well.
Second power play goal of the period for the Lightning. Here comes Forsberg in with a shot, and that's handled by Vasilevsky. Puck popped out, and now
to this one, that's going to be a lot of fun to watch the rest of this game. It was the hit by Johansson that led to eventually a 2-minute minor penalty for a legal check to the head. Chernak unhappy about it, missed some time in the game, and then right here at Belmar, Johansson go at it. Maru gave him a little shot there too, Johnson. Yes, he did. And it's not over yet.
Ballard back out for foot.
Barry knocks the puck down, and then eventually Tampa's going to find Steven Stamkos, and they get a 2-goal lead.
It is a power play for the Predators, trailing by two.
seconds here.
Now 3 seconds.
This game ends in much the same manner it was contested.
The Lightning ruins the party for Nashville on Saturday as they won their fourth consecutive game. Steven Stamkos led the way for Tampa Bay with 3 points and also extended his goal streak to 4 games in the victory. Here's Jamie Hirsch after the game with Braden Point.
What a game down the stretch. The crowd's back in it. It was a one-goal game. How'd you hold them off down the stretch?
Good defense. Guys were selling off blocking shots, and they were coming, you know, in the third period. I thought they had a lot of momentum. They're kind of taking it to us, but able to hold it up. As he made some big saves like he always does, and like I say, this guy's selling off blocking shots and able to close it out.
3-point night for your captain. What is it like to play with Steven Stamkos? Describe him as a leader.
Yeah, he's great, and he's having one heck of a year this year, and he's just a competitor, and he's so talented and great in the room. And it's a pleasure, and he's working extremely hard and getting rewarded, so it's great to see.
And this is your first outdoor game. When you first walked out there and saw 69,000 fans outdoors, what was that moment like?
Absolutely incredible. Just such a cool atmosphere, and crowd was rocking from both sides. There's a lot of noise for both teams, and I want to thank all the Tampa fans that came out. We had a great showing, and the boys really appreciated it.
What's your biggest takeaway from the weekend?
Oh, just how fun it was. A lot of guys had family down, kids, wives, and just to share the experience with them, it was great. And to do it with the guys we got in the room, we're a really close group, and we're all good friends in there. So it was a blast.
Pat Maroon says you guys are going out to Tootsie's after this. Going to be a late night or what?
I don't know. I gotta get some food, and then we'll see what happens from there.
We'll see what happens. All right, thanks for the time. Congrats.
Thank you.
Love it. I'm sure it's going to be a fun night. Our own Braden Point netted his 20th goal of the season in Saturday's win, which is the fifth straight season that he's reached that milestone. Only 4 other Bolts have done that in more consecutive seasons, with current teammates Steven Stamkos and Nikita Kucherov among them. With more on the game, let's head back out to Nashville. Here's Kevin Weeks and Jamie Hirsch.
Well, we always say when the spotlight shines bright, it's your best players that need to be your best players. And it certainly seemed like that tonight for Tampa. We got Stamkos with a 3-point night. We have Victor Hedman getting involved, Kucherov getting involved. What stood out most to you about Tampa?
They really played to their strength offensively. They didn't have to go in search of getting